the day the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Indeed, it's a day of joy and celebration as we come to hear God's word and receive from him the blessings as he comes to us in our worship service this morning. Today we celebrate All Saints Day, and during the course of the service you will hear our songs, our hymns, and our liturgy will reflect the reality, our order of service, the divine service setting one. Just a couple of announcements before we begin. I'd like a moment of silence for all the Ohio State Buckeyes. That was a great victory tonight by Michigan. Did anyone else win? Did you and I? That's good. Our hearts go out to Ohio State fans, but next week. Also, just a couple of reminders. Don't forget, if you haven't yet signed up for your pictures, please do so. It begins this coming, tomorrow, we'll begin taking pictures. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday, there's still lots of time slots available. We want to get as many, in fact, we'd love to have all of you participate in that so we can have a full and complete picture directory. Also, I want to remind you, between services today, we're going to have a question and answer period discussing our proposed new confirmation program, a way of instructing and raising up our children in the faith. It's very different. It's a radical change from what we've done in the past. We'd like the congregation to take serious consideration of this and then vote on it at our coming meeting on November 19th. That's our regular congregational gathering on the 19th. So if you'd like more information, if you have some questions, please stay around between services today and we'll try to answer this for you to the best of our ability. Any other announcements we're supposed to make? I think that's it. Let's take a moment and share the peace of Christ with those around us.
Sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought,
Almighty God in his mercy has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called, ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The first reading for this commemoration of All Saints Day found in the 7th chapter of Revelation, beginning at the 9th verse as follows. After this, John the Apostle writes, after this, I beheld a great multitude that no one could number, from every tribe, nation, and from all tribes and people and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb. And all the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the live four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, who are these dressed in white robes, and from where have they come? And I said to him, sir, you know. And he said to me, these are the ones coming out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb in the midst of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is found in the first John, chapter 3, beginning verse 1. See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it does not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, and what we will be has not yet appeared. But we know that when he appears, we should be like him, because we shall see him as he is. And everyone who thus hopes in him purifies him as he is pure. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand in honor of the Holy Gospel. down the front here. Good morning. Because